Hey, what's up, guys? It is Effect here bringing us another video. Hope you guys have a great day so far today. And we're going to go over the Season Pass 2 now. We're going to go over everything that I saw at the Tokyo Masters that was released by Harada. And he released a lot of stuff, man. A lot of stuff. Now, this is going to be a one take. Tell you that now, I kind of already messed up. Who cares? But anyway, it's going to be a one take, really. Who cares too much about if I mess up or not? If I stutter, I stutter. If I mess up, I mess up. If I pause, I pause. Don't care too much. But anyway, we're going to go over everything here. All the screenshots are in Japanese, so, you know, if you can't read it, don't worry. If you can, that's cool, because I can't read Japanese. Okay, so let's go over everything here. So, basically, this screenshot is showing us the prices for the characters in the Season Pass. So, basically, Leia and Anna are going to be released separately for $5. Now, you don't have to pay for the Season Pass. That's always been an option for some reason. You don't have to actually pay for it. You can get the characters that are going to be added to the game separately. And just play those characters if you want to, have fun with it, whatever. If you don't want to go in depth into the game, that's understandable, which is why I understand why, you know, they're going pretty balls deep with this thing and actually we're not releasing it with the Season Pass, so we don't have to actually pay for everything that's in there. So the Season Pass altogether is going to be $28 roughly. Now, that's kind of a lot being a consumer, but, you know, as a passionate Tekken player, I don't care too much about price. I'll pay for anything, but if it's like unreasonable pricing, you know, I'm not gonna buy it. You know, don't be stupid. I'm just saying that now. But anyway, let's get into the next screenshot here. So this screenshot is showing us the auto combo system. Now, basically, this is for newcomers. I'm not gonna go too much in depth to it, but basically, if you, let's say you press 111 or 222, 333, 444, or whatever they're gonna make the system as, you can basically just, you know, press the button and keep pressing 111, and it'll create a combo. And this seems to be much for newcomers, which is what I understand, because this game is complex. But it, you know, it's a great system, and I don't know why people are complaining, but it's for newcomers, not the pro players. So don't worry about it too much. Anyway, don't complain too much yet. But let's get into this ranking system that they have now. They're actually going to show you a progression bar for yourself. Now, you can see where you're at in terms of ranking and your points, which is good, because I don't want to stress too much anymore, because I be stressing, boys. I be stressing. But, they're actually going to show you where you're at, and actually you can get full points of the person below you, which is cool, because why not? Why not, man? But that's really cool. That's actually going to show us our progression, which is good. And you don't have to stress too much anymore about where you're at, because you don't have to count your points. You can actually just look at where you're at now, which is cool. So all the characters actually getting new moves. I would say some of them are getting buffed, some of them are getting nerfed. So we're going to actually see what's going to be buffed and what's going to be nerfed. It's going to be a screenshot release later on. I'm not sure when, but we will go over everything later. And I'm going to kind of analyze this video later by myself. And I want you guys to analyze it for yourself as well. And look at all the new moves and stuff like that if you play a certain character. Now, this is just, you know, bits and pieces of everything that we're seeing here. We don't see everything here. So you cannot go off of what you see here. This is just bits and pieces of everything here. Now, Kazumi, that buff, man. That fucking buff. But we don't know, you know, if she's getting nerfed. Obviously, she's going to get nerfed, depending on if we hate her or not in a playing. We don't hate characters here. I actually like all the characters, even Lily now. I used to hate Lily so much. But, you know, you just got to get over it and play through it. You know, there's nothing we can do about it. It's in the game for a reason. So if it's in the game for a reason, you know, just learn to play around it. And, you know, that's pretty much all you can do with this game. Just pretty much learn. So that King buff right there, the sidestep 2, is a corkscrew. Now, it seems like they're giving a lot of these characters new corkscrews and stuff like that. And it seems like a lot of these characters got nerfed, from what I'm seeing. Some of them got nerfed a lot, by what I'm seeing just here by itself. Now, everything is being, you know, everything has different properties now. And, you know, certain moves do certain things at the wall now. Or, you know, just do different things now. Now, it seems like a lot of the characters are getting buffed. And then some of the characters who were, like, too strong, I would say. Like, a Dragunov or Kazumi. Maybe even a Paul. They're probably going to get nerfed the most, I would say. But I think just because it's just too strong, you know. Frame-wise, it could be strong. Power-wise, it could be strong. And, you know, just movement-wise, it could be too strong. And they're just getting nerfed. I mean, that's pretty much it. And the characters that were too, like, weak, I would say, like, mostly being Lee, out of all aspects, is, like, the weakest character. And I would say he's probably going to get, like, buffed a lot, considering the fact that he's pretty weak. Now, I'm actually going to say that Devil Jin, in my opinion, it's probably the best Mishima because, you know, that health sweep, whatever. So, if they hit that health sweep, nothing you can do about it. I would say he makes all the Mishimas look pretty weak, but I would say Kazuya is pretty strong. considering the fact that you just throw electrics out there and stuff like that, that's pretty much what you do anyway, and just use your 50-50 health sweep with Kazuya. So I'm saying that, you know, don't nerf Dewajin too much. Don't make him, like, retarded. Because if he is, then he's going to be the weakest out of all of them, I would say. And now, for the Panda Bears, I don't even know why they end the game. Like, I don't understand why Kuma and Panda are in the game. I just don't understand. I hate those characters so much, only because of the hitbox. That's pretty much it. Eliza has a 10-frame punish now. But I am glad that they actually put that in the game. My friend does play Eliza. He's very committed to her. And actually just might become the best Eliza player in the world. Considering the fact that a lot of people are just dropping her for some reason. And he's actually really good with her. So I'm actually glad that they actually put that in the game. But hope you guys enjoyed the video. Make sure you guys leave a like and sub to the channel. And make sure you guys follow me on Twitch. I will be streaming this on the 6th. I will be buying everything that's going to be provided with this Season Pass 2. And showing everything off on Twitch. And I will upload to YouTube if you guys are the YouTube base. Thank you guys for being here, and I will see you guys in the next video. Peace out.